Hi all, I am Mudassir. This is the tutorial first of Cadence. In this tutorial, I'll be showing how to launch Virtuoso, followed by circuit implementation, and then some basic simulations will be done. So first of all, we'll launch Virtuoso. For that, we have to go to our open terminal command. Here, I'll give some commands. So what actually I am doing here, I am invoking one file here, chrc. As you see in this folder, there is this file is here. So all the tools which are in Cadence, they have been invoked here, the path is defined here. So whenever I am going to use any tool of my Virtuoso Cadence, so I have to source it first using this command. So now this Virtuoso is launched. So this is the command interface window. Here I can see different utilities which are present in Cadence, different tools, how many licenses I have, and various other things. So if you are using this tool first time, so first of all you have to create your own library. For that I'll go to this tools and then library manager, file, new library. Here I'll give some library name. Let's give it tutorials. Okay so now this library has been created, but which technology I'm going to use I have to define. Like there will be 180 nanometer, 90 nanometer, 45 65 55 UMC. So for that I'll go here, attach to an existing technology library, and okay, so it will show the different technology, different foundry files which are available for me. So I am using 180 nanometer here, so I'll select this and okay. Now this library is created here. So whenever I am going to do my work, I have to go to this particular library and create my circuits or design my circuits and do my simulation. So first of all I'll click on this, and then I'll go again to file, and then I'll select on salary. Here, for the sake of demonstration, I will do the circuit implementation of inverter, and some basic simulation we'll do in this tutorial. So let's give it name inverter. So this is the screen, this is the workspace where we are going to implement different transistors, use different transistors. So far these are different options here, like file, save, you want to save or edit. We'll discuss them each option by time. So first of all I will design my inverter circuit. So I hope you all be knowing the operation and design that circuit design of inverter. I'll just create instance. So by going there I'll find my own transistor which I have to use. So library browse, since I'm using 180 nanometer technology, so I'll go here and I'll choose NMOS. This is N and symbol. I'll just close it. For sake of demonstration we'll just keep it like this, because we want to see the circuit, how to do the circuit implementation and these things. Later on we can discuss design also. So this is it, this is the NMOS. Now see, I can, if I want more than one NMOS, I can just click it, it will go on how many numbers are on, it will go on. But since I need only one here, so I'll just press escape, it will go again in select mode. I'll select these and I'll delete them. Okay, so one is like, now I want PMOS, again I'll go here and again browse, since this is selected here, and I'll go and I'll find PMOS. So this is PMOS symbol. Again let's keep it, actually it should be 2.5 times of the NMOS, that width. So, but let's keep it like this. So here. Now I want to zoom them. So one way is to click on your right click and drag this box over this. It will zoom. Or just press F. So it will fit. Now I'll do connections. There are three ways of connections. One is I'll just go drag this transistor on this and drag it back. So this is one way of doing connections. Otherwise, I'll go here, I'll drag mouse while clicking on left button of my mouse and dragging. So by this way I can create this wire. One more way is I'll go here, this is wire, I'll just click on this and I can do my connections, like for VDD this and these two. Okay, so here again this is for input, this is for, so this is done. Next is I have to give voltage sources and ground to different terminals. So for that again I'll go here. So the voltage source, they are not provided by the foundry, they'll be in analog lib. So here I'll just type V pulse. Okay, so symbol, and let's give some DC voltage 0.6, and I want it that pulse, it should be 1.0 to 1.8. means take period of 1 micro. You want to show if you want to take delay time, rise time, fall time, pulse width, any pulse width you want to give, you can give, but by default it will take half of this in pulse width. Rest is 000. So let's keep it like that. So again here, next thing is I'll give some power supply here, VDD. So for that, again I'll go here and browse VDD, sorry, VDC. Remove. Power supply is 1.8. Yeah. Next thing is I'll just connect it here. Okay, ground is that ground will be in this level, so I can just replace it here, it will come automatically. No need to go there back. Ground here, ground. So this is the schematic of inverter. Now whenever you draw some circuit, you have to check and save. It will check for any errors or there are warnings. Generally warnings we can skip, like here this net is open, so it is showing its one warning. If there is some complex circuit and you are not able to find where is the warning address, you can go for shift and G. You press shift and G, it will show you where that warning is. So you can remove that by giving some name or something. So what I will do, it I will keep it like this. Next is once check and save is done, no warning, no error is there, then I'll go launch for simulations and I'll go this ADL. This is analog design environment. So this is our basic simulations. So this is the, this place is for here we have to choose different types of analysis we want to do, like DC, AC, transient, pole zero, stability, many simulations are there we can do here. Here in this block we have to choose our outputs, what outputs we want to see. Here if we are keeping some variables in our circuit, for example we are keeping variable our DC bias here, or width of this, length of this, or any other parameter we are keeping variable, we can give it here. So for now only two things we are doing. First thing is we have to choose analysis. So this is like thumb rule, whenever we are going to do any analysis, first we have to do DC analysis to see whether our circuit is in those operating conditions or not, EV transistor operating conditions. So one way is to go here analysis and choose, or here is a shortcut if it is visible to you. So I'll go here, choose. So first of all DC, and I will say DC operating points. Okay, so next thing is I'll go for transient analysis, and since I given I think 2 micro, so I'll give here 10 micro, so, and I'll keep this order rate. Okay, now I have to see the outputs. What outputs I want to see? I'll go here outputs, and I'll say to be plotted, select on schematic, then I'll select this and this. Net 3 is out and net 1 is input. This is done, so then I can go for simulation. It's taking a bit of time, just waiting for the license, searching for license. So this is the transient response, this is our input, this is our output. This is the basic simulation which we can do. If you go here again, your analysis, see there are different types of analysis here: transient, DC, AC, noise, pole zero, sensitivity, DC mismatch, stability, and these are for RF applications. So for now we are just doing basic one. In coming tutorials I will go to UV simulation and we'll discuss about those. So now this block is remaining, design variables. How to use design variables? So I'll go for this, I'll go for properties. You can right click here and go for properties, or you can just press Q and this one again. Let's keep it variable X. I'll keep it X. Okay, so whenever I'm doing some change in my schematic, I do again check and save. So once this is done, again I'll go to my this window. Here I have to add this variable. Now the variable I kept here, I have to add it here. So variables, copy from cell view, it will copy all the variables which are in my schematic. So X, let's give it 0.6. So now what I will do, I'll vary this X from 0 to 1.8, and again I'll run it. Now I am sweeping this X from 0 to 1.8, which is input bias. So I'll see the effect, what is happening at the output. So this will give me an idea of my circuit, how it's behaving for my different for my input range. If I'm varying from 0 to power supply VDD, so how my circuit is operating. Again it's taking time. So it's done, I think. Yeah. This is just one mistake. So I hope you might have seen these things in your books. This is the DC characteristics of inverter. So this is the transient response. So the input is varying from 0 to 1.8, and accordingly our output is varying like this. So this is the basic of Cadence Virtuoso. Next, in next tutorial we'll be discussing about how to create symbol, and we'll talk about some more analysis like AC. Will go in next tutorial. So hope you like this. If you have any questions, you can comment below. I'll be happy to help you as much as I can. Thank you.